Hello guys, welcome back to Tesca Technologies Private Limited. My name is Shivam Vijay and today in this video I am going to give a demonstration on single phase variable inductive load. So in this video we will be see the complete construction of this inductive load, how the inductive load varies its value. We will check the value also in the millihenries using an LCR meter, and then after we will be provide a single phase power source supply to this inductive load and check the ampere rating, what are the current it drawing from this inductive load. This type of inductive load generally designed to carry out the power output or the power efficiency of any of the single phase source which is generated by using a generator, or you can use this inductive load for the calibration purpose as well. Different type of power supplies can be used to calibrate it according to the inductive behavior. You can find out the characteristics of any sources using this inductive load. So this is a basic inductive load. This can be also used in a laboratory for experimental purpose also. So we'll do some basic practical responses of this inductive load in this video. So this is a closer look of the single phase variable inductive load, 0 to 10 ampere. The order code is 19204576.11. You can use this order code to find out all the specification about this by visiting our website, which is www.tescaglobal.com. So this was a complete closer loop. Now I will explain you the complete structure of this inductive load. So this is having complete metal frame design with a wheels alignment, so you can easily move this load as the load has a very higher in weight, so that movement of this load with the wheels are very useful, so that you can easily move this load to apply it any of the sources. These are the two input terminals of the coil that is connected in this inductive load. The construction of the inductive load are designed as per the course, are separated in two parts, the upper E and the lower E. The lower E is the fixed to the frame and upper E is the movable using this pulley, so that this screw pulley can be pull up the inductive loads, or the upper E which is a movable E like this. When you tighten this pulley, the load or the upper E of this load will be going upwards, so that the screw is tightening. The four struts on complete side is provided for supporting this with the spring, of course, so that it can easily repel when you again loosen down these pulleys. So this is how the E part of this core or the core will be moved from the half of this part, and the value of the millihenry is as per design, that the when core goes upwards the value decreases of the millihenry, and when the cores go downwards the value of the millihenry will be increases. Simultaneously the current will be minimum when the core, both the cores are close to each other, and when the both the cores are very farther, then where there is a gap in between both upper and lower core, the current will be higher. So here I have connected a LCR meter to measurement the inductance of the inductive load. Here right now, as the LCR meter shows you, it is right now measuring the inductance is about 302 millihenry. We can consider is around near about 300 millihenry. This is the maximum millihenries that is offering right now. At this time the current will be minimum whenever we can connect any of the single phase source to this, and as I varies the load using this screw pulley, the load slightly decreases the value of millihenry, and as I tighten the pulley some more, the value of millihenry continuously goes down. So as the value is going down of the millihenry, so at this time the current value which is drawing from this load will be higher. So let us completely tighten the pulley and let us see what is the minimum millihenry is offered from this load. this is only for demonstration, and in the demonstration I am going completely at the fast rate to tighten this pulley. Do not try to do the complete faster changes and faster variable at this speed when you connected this to the load, so that it will harm you or also it will harm the load as well. Right now you can see in the LCR meter, this is showing that it is right now 51.33 millihenry is the minimum from this, and we can consider 52 millihenry is the minimum offering for neglecting some tolerance also. Now we again pull this to close towards both the cores, and after that we will provide a single phase power source to this supply and we'll do the current practical. We'll use a digital multimeter to measure the current in series with both the supplies. At both the terminal we will provide single phase supply and check the behavior of this inductive load with the ampere range of about to 10 ampere, measuring the ampere in the multimeter. So here I have connected the complete setup. I have provided the single phase supply with the power source over here, and we have used the multimeter to measure the AC current. We just turned this to the AC measurement. Right now no current is measured by the meter as the supply source is in off condition. So multimeter for current measurement is connected in series right now, and now we'll turn on the power source and let us see what is the effect. Here you can see at the 300 millihenry value, which is the maximum for this, the current drawing from the multimeter, we can see from this load it is about 1.63 amperes. Now I will again turn off the load and increase the load or the decrease the millihenry, so that current value will be slightly increased. Here I have provided some of the gap in both the cores of this inductive load, and now again I will turn on the power source. Here you can see the current is increased up to 3.57 milliamperes. Humming noise is due to the current passing through, and the difference between the core is very low. When we go to the more current drawing, the humming noise will be goes down. So that was the some more about 3 amperes. Now we again increase the load of this coil, so millihenries will be some more increased, and at this time let us see what is the current drawn. So current drawn is about 4.83, we can see approx 5 amperes from this load. Similarly we again turn off the load. Make sure always turn off the load when you increase the current or current capacity or the load capacity. Do not increase the load while connected with the power source. Here you can see as the current is increasing, humming noise is going down, and we can see the load is drawing about 5.73 amperes. Now we turn off the load again, increase the supply, increase the load capacity, inductance, and again measure the load, which is I found about 7.5 amperes. So the load can draw up to and withstand up to 7.5 amperes. So we'll again increase the capacity of this. Here we have reached about 8.5 from this, and now for the last we'll increase it completely and let us see what is the maximum load is drawn from this. Also, we need to make sure the load will not be going 10 amperes, more than 10 amperes, because the meter has only the 10 amperes fused. So we'll do not provide more than 90% load to this. For this practical here, 9.8, and the humming noise is completely very low. So we can say the load can withstand about 10 amperes of the load with the single phase power supply. So this is how you can study the load, apply this load to any of your single phase power source to checking it or the capacity or efficiency of that source. So that was the complete demonstration of the single phase inductive load with the 10 amperes of power rating. This is a variable single phase inductive load in which we have seen that when the value of the inductance is higher, the current drawn from the load is very lower, and when the value of the inductance is lower, which is about 50 millihenry, the current drawn from the load will be higher. So that's how the load behaves, and you can use the load as per your settings as a variable load, so that you can provide any of the sources using this load, so that you can verify your load checking, also calibrate any of the load, any of the power source to this using this single phase inductive load. If you like the content of this video, the video is useful for you. If you find that useful, you can like this video, and also you can share this video to your friends, to your colleagues, those who want to learn about of inductive load, how the inductive load works. So I have a channel which is Tesca Tech on YouTube. There are a lot of video with different type of practical information with different type of educational trainers are uploaded. So you can go through that and clear your interesting topics of the educational sector. And don't forget to press the bell button, so whenever we upload our new video with a new trainer, with a new technology that I am explaining in the video, you will get the notification about that as well. Till then, thank you for watching this video, and we will meet in the next video very soon.